Y'all can't see it, but I can. Okay, guys, it's about 6:45. And the most challenging thing I gotta do this morning is just climb about 100 yards up at Edge's power line right up here, probably ain't that far, without blowing a deer out. It's gonna be hard too, man, because they burn this corner up. I try to look as good as I can before I move, man. Instead of just going straight across, I'm gonna stay over here in the edge of all this stuff so I can stay hid. Right, guys, I just had a deer was coming right across the point right to me and got just right over there. I guess he seen me. And he bound back around the point not far at all. And I think it's the same deer I jumped in here the other morning. He was coming off here at the same time. Right there's that blind I put together. That way at least man will be able to hunt right here on the ground, you know. And deer ain't gonna, they're not gonna see through that. See here, and be able to sneak up the edge of this like I did this morning, come up and hit this road. We got another deer coming down the power line. been long ago killed. There he is. burning up. And my mouth is dry as, man. My mouth couldn't be no drier if I was sitting here eating dirt. Boys, that's what I'm talking about right there. These deer are on a grunt call and a bleat call. I don't know which one he's coming to. I think it's both. I think it's where I do both. Now, he's young. Did you see how big that deer was, man? I mean, I could have drawed on that deer. And as soon as he come out of that little, I mean, he give me the perfect opportunity when he come out of this little patch of beach right here, feeding on these acorns. Boys, it's 11:30, and this particular power line. Now, see, I'm out to the one. I'm right here beside the second pole. So I'm about 150 yards away from where we was at. But I'm building a blind in this. There's a big dead tree fell across this power line all the way across it right here. And old dude's old tree stand is built right here. You know, I would love, dude, man, the guy that's built these tree stands in this power line. I don't know if you're from Coal Mountain. I don't know if you're from Long Branch. I don't know if you're from OCA. I don't know where you're from, dude. I don't even know if you're still alive. But I found that old buck rub line right here yesterday. And man, I would love, if there's any by chance that anybody knows this guy that hung these tree stands down here, or if you are still with us, old timer, because I know you're older, probably older than me now, I would love to know the stories on these tree stands. I've known these stands was here for a long time. Either you killed that big monarch monster buck, and his seeds long in this mountain, or you didn't. And I would love to know if somebody could put me in contact with his kin or you, if you're alive. Guys, that's what it's all about. That's why I leave myself climber down there in the car. I've seen him run through his freaking power line. Now, would he went all the way up to my blind? I ain't had a deer yet. They'll cross this one, drop down, and that's it. I don't see them anymore. Perfect setup, man. And boys, if you do hunt out of it, don't f*** up and piss in it and shit, man. Take care of this thing. There'll be some big bucks killed out of it. It's 12:15. Here's this trail. The exact trail he's on's right there. Right on around through where. And I built that blind up there on top of the where the power line starts up there. Looks like that belongs there. And they've been, you know, they know that tree's there. That right there, that'll work, guys. There. I'm gonna cut some more beech leaves and finish that right there. But down the back, you know, your head too on the backside.